Your words, your thoughts, your cells, your emotions, they're all connected. How can you use that to achieve your dream? I had to learn that myself, and I really want you to understand this really simple principle so that you can achieve what you want, so that you can have a career and a life that you love, so that you can be the one that people are looking up to, like, oh my gosh, I love your life, I want what you have, right? And it's really, really simple, but I'm gonna dive deeper into this so that you really understand, okay? Because yes, you know, you can read all about it, and you may have heard, like, oh, your thoughts and your body are connected. Your mind and your body are connected. Yes, great. What does that really, really mean? And how can you use that? When I learned that, when I really learned to use the power of my mind, the power of the thoughts, oh my gosh. And I'm still doing that every single day. Every single day, I'm using the power of my thoughts. Every single day, when I have a moment that I feel down, when I have a moment that I doubt myself, when I have a moment that I'm in fear, I use this power of my mind. I control my mind, and my day goes well. And I'm achieving my dream. And I am achieving the goals and the dreams that I wanted. And years ago, I was stuck in a job, and I didn't use the power of my mind, and I kept stuck in that job. Because all I was telling me was the wrong language. I was giving myself the wrong words. And maybe you're doing the same thing. So I'm gonna dive deeper into this and just make sure that, please, if you like my video, you hit that like button, you leave a comment below, you would really help me with that. And you hit the subscribe button if you haven't done so already. Also that little notification bell, because I make videos every single week and I wanna inspire and motivate you to achieve the life of your dreams, to escape that job if you want to escape that job, to have a career that you love, to have the life that people are like, oh, you're so lucky. And no, it's not luck, because you can create it for yourself, knowing what steps to take, and that's what I'm here for. So here's a really important thing, and that is the power of the mind. Okay, so let me break it down for you. The power of your thoughts. If you think positive thoughts, and I'm not gonna say, oh, woo-woo, life is all rosy. No, it's not, okay? So just bear with me here for a moment. If you think positive thoughts or optimistical thoughts, you will feel more optimistic. If you think negative thoughts, if you think fearful thoughts, you will feel that tension and that fear. Just a really simple example. If you're thinking about, you're laying in bed at night and you're thinking there's a burglar in your house, just imagine there's a burglar in your house. You suddenly feel that your heart is beating, you're sweating, you're having this tension in your stomach because you're literally thinking, oh my gosh, there's a burglar in my house, and you feel that in your body. And that's it. That's it. That's the connection, because you're thinking that thought, it creates that feeling. So when you're thinking, oh, I can't achieve that, then you're telling your body you can't achieve it. Now, how is it possible that your mind and body is so connected? Because our cells in our body, and we have about 40 trillion cells in our body, they are eavesdropping on our thoughts. So whatever you tell yourself, the language that you're using, the words that you're using in your mind, you're actually directing it to your cells, and your cells are behaving up on that, right? So if you keep telling yourself, I can't, I can't, I can't, you're not going to be able to do anything, right? Because you can't. You're telling yourself, I can't, so that's what you're going to get. You are communicating that to your cells. You're communicating to your body, like, hey, I'm in fear. I'm having fearful thoughts. I'm having doubts about myself. I can't do that. I'm not good enough. And you're totally telling yourself, you're communicating that. So what's going to happen? Nothing, because you're in fear, you're in anxiety, and you're not going to take action because you can't. You're telling yourself you can't. So, you know, why would you achieve a goal if you can't, right? You're telling yourself you can't. Now, by changing that inner dialogue, by shifting your thoughts, you influence that chemistry in your body, right? So by shifting your thoughts and thinking optimistic thoughts and thinking about the things that you want to achieve, that is how you will make it happen. There's one important aspect also, is that when you attach to your, you desire something and you attach to it, you attach to the outcome, that is based on fear. If you always focus on the result and the outcome, it's based on fear. If you can detach from the result or the outcome, that is based on a belief in yourself, right? So everything you want to achieve in your life, it starts with believing in yourself, trusting yourself. Detach from the outcome. It's the same as saying like marry the process and divorce the results, right? So enjoy the process. Whenever you have a big dream, you want to have another career, you want to start your own business. Like I help my clients to transition from their job, their soul-sucking job that they really don't like, into finding their passion and turning that passion into income, right? So it's that transition of, okay, how can you stop thinking, oh, I'm in this job and I hate this job, and how can you transition into doing more of what you love, but trusting that process? If you don't have faith in yourself, if you don't believe in yourself, if you don't trust yourself, it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen because you still are stuck in fear. And in other words, when I was a few years back and I was still in my corporate, I was using the same language all the time. Like people are like, oh, what are you doing, Rachel? I'm like, oh, I'm a manager and I'm in this job and I really don't like it. And that's what I kept telling. Those are the words that I kept telling myself. Because I didn't believe I was able to quit. I didn't believe I could have money online and have my own coaching business online and sell courses and books. And I didn't believe that. I didn't trust in myself. Because all I was telling myself in those words, in that language, was like, I'm a manager and I'm in a job and I really don't like it. And so I was telling all the cells in my body, like, I'm not liking my life and that's my life. And nothing's gonna happen. No. The moment I learned the power of the thoughts, and there's a small experiment that I did to just to prove this point, and it's another video. Well, I will link it right here and link it down below in the description. It's with a pendulum, and it's actually showing you the power of our thoughts. So in the pendulum, you hold the pendulum in your hands. In short, this is what it is. You close your eyes for 30 seconds to 1 minute. And you're telling, you know, in your mind, you're telling, okay, the pendulum is turning in circles. The pendulum is turning in circles. You open your eyes after 1 minute and you will see that the pendulum is actually turning circles. And then you do it again. You close your eyes. You hold your hand really steady and you're telling yourself, okay, it's moving left to right. It's moving left to right. And you open your eyes after 1 minute and it's actually moving left to right. It's like it's so strong that your thoughts dictate your behavior without, you know, with just holding it, like seriously. So your thoughts dictate the cells, dictate your behavior, dictate your emotions. So everything starts here, okay? So the moment when I was still in my corporate job that I started telling, like, I want freedom. I want a life of freedom. I want to travel the world. I want to meet new people. I want to help other people achieve their dreams. And I am living that dream and I am traveling. And the moment I started changing those words, oh my gosh, like other people showed up in my life. Opportunities showed up in my life. I was looking in that direction. I was opening myself to possibilities instead of limiting myself into those words of, no, I can't. I'm not, you know, I'm stuck. I'm stuck in this job. I'm stuck, right? So the words, the power of your words that you put into your mind, it's incredible, incredible. So I want you to start shifting constantly. So first of all, pay attention to the thoughts that you're having, the language and the words that you're using, and then shift them into, I can do this. Like, yes, I can go towards my goal. I can do this. I can achieve that. I can. And that is it's going to start to trust yourself more and believe in yourself, because you're telling yourself, I can do this. I trust myself. That is what you're telling yourselves, and you are going to trust and believe in yourself, and you are going to take steps to achieve your goal and your dream. That is exactly how I'm helping my clients. So always take next steps. But the mindset, without mindset, actions is nothing. You have to have the mindset, the trust and the belief, and just, you know, facing those fearful thoughts and thinking, no, it's fine. It's fine. I'm fine. I will be fine. Okay? So give your brain the good stuff. Okay? Remember, junk food junk brain. Good food, good brain. Like, it just, it works, okay? So the power of your mind, check out that other video. If you're still feeling stuck, I have a free training to get you unstuck. It's right down below in the description. If you want to talk to me about this, if you want to escape and have a clear plan, a roadmap to escape your and transition from your job into becoming an online entrepreneur, please let me help you. Let's just have a talk. Let's just have a chat. I'm happy to help you. So I'll see you again next week. Make sure to subscribe, hit that like button, and I love, love, love reading your comments below.